Alright dudes, I was flicking through a book the other day by Robert Lawler, and I found this image.
It shows how the flower of life can be used to find a bunch of equilateral shapes, and I wanted to see if I could draw it. It was a bit harder than I thought it would be. I kept hitting dead ends, and it started getting very mathematical. I might be wrong, but it seemed to me that the image in the book was incomplete, so I had to stray a little and find my own method, and here's what I ended up using. I'm going to start off by making two rows of circles using the Flower of Life grid. I'll draw three circles on the bottom row and four circles on the top. And the main focus of this will be the trinity of circles in the middle. So the two on the top and the one on the bottom. And the two on the top will form the Vesica Piscis, which everything will come out of. So right in the middle, we've got the Vesica Piscis, and I'm going to use that to draw a line down the middle. Then I'm going to set the compass to the length of that line and draw a circle. So the first polygon is easy to find. It's a triangle, and I'll make it by connecting these two points inside of the Vesica Piscis. I'll project these lines to the edge of the bigger circle because these lines will help create the other polygons. Connect these two points, and that'll be the bottom of all the polygons. I'll use those same points to draw two more vertical lines that will go from top to bottom. And that tells me exactly where the square is. I'll use these points on the left and right of the bottom circle, connect them to the top point of the same circle, and project them. Then I can use those intersections to make the sides of the pentagon. To find the top of the pentagon, I have to set the compass to the length of the sides. The point where the circles cross is the top of the pentagon. All right. The hexagon is easy because circles love to be divided into six. If I connect these intersections that we made right at the start with the circles, then use this line that's coming off the triangle to form the other half of the shape. Alright, now it's going to get complicated. I'll connect these intersections down here to the bottom corners of the polygons. Then join the corners of the square and project the lines out. All of the sides of these shapes are exactly the same size. The compass is still set to the length of the sides of these shapes. I'll put it here and draw a circle. Same on the other side, of course. Now there's part of the octagon. I need to use the compass again to find the top of the shape. And there it is. The next shape is the decagon, and it uses the pentagon to show where the top is. You have to connect the corners of the pentagon and project the lines. Here's where it crosses the circle that was used to create the pentagon in the first place. Now I'm going to pull out the compass again to close off the shape. Okay, now for the dodecagon. This uses the trinity of circles at the bottom to create the edges at the bottom. Then I'll join the corners of this hexagon and project the lines out, and that will map out the left and right part of the shape. To top it off, I'll have to extend these lines a little bit, then use the compass. And that should do it. So every side of every shape should be the exact same length. In the end, I found that it wasn't 100% accurate, which was a bit disappointing, but still pretty interesting. Let me know what you think in the comments, and if you enjoyed this, hit the like button. Thanks for watching. Ta-ra.